Mats Madu, we are the children, we are the children of God. Come, 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 we change our world, we have what it takes to do it smart and make it smart. Welcome to our Smart Do.
Hello, Class 5 pupils, how are you? Welcome again to another lesson, a science lesson. We looked at sound, we looked at loud and soft sound. So loud sound is produced when things are released from a high level or from a higher height. And when you release things from a lower light, they produce soft sound. We say that amplifying sound or increasing the loudness of sound is called amplification. And we looked at ways of amplifying or increasing the loudness of sound. So today we are going to look at sound pollution. Remember, English people say that too much of everything is not good, it's dangerous. So, too much sound can be dangerous. And, for example, you are in the classroom and there's no teacher, you know what you like doing most, I'll not go deep into that. You realize that people from the back are talking, others on this side are talking different things, others in the middle are talking. Another one is just jumping up and down, singing. So, somebody from outside, will he hear anything from inside? No, you'll not be able to understand what these people are saying. Because some are speaking in English, others in Swahili. These are talking about a journey they had. Others here are talking about how the weekend was, how they went for swimming. Others on the back are talking about what they ate tonight. Others are singing what they sang on Sunday, maybe. So there will be a lot of many different sounds from that classroom. And in that case, we say the class is making what? The class is making noise. So what is noise? Noise is unwanted sound. Noise is unwanted sound. And we say noise is a form of sound pollution. When you are making noise, you are doing sound pollution. I've given you an example. For example, pupils in a class, you just go into class, or the teacher comes out of the class, then one row will start singing a song in Kiswahili, the middle row they will start singing another song, maybe in English, others on the front part will start singing maybe another song, a gospel song on they sang on Sunday, others from behind they will be singing another different song, maybe in their mother tongue. Others will just be singing the rumba songs. Others will just be singing very many different types of songs. So nobody will be understanding what these people are doing. So that is what we call sound. I mean noise. Noise is unwanted sound. What are some of the sources of sound? For example, you go to the market. In the market, that is nearby, you just go to the market. Then in the market, you'll hear very many different types of sound from different people. You'll hear people, the makanga guys calling people to their vehicles. The mama mboga will be calling you to buy their mbogas. The mitumba men will be hawking their mitumba, calling you to buy their mitumba clothes. Others will be calling you to go to eat to their hotels. Others will be selling to you things like the hawkers, you know what they do. They're selling the mayai sausage, maji, biscuit, soda, those types of sound. So one source of sound is in the marketplaces. Noise from the marketplaces. We can also have noise from vehicles hooting. You just go to the stage, then every vehicle is producing a different type. The vehicles, the so-called the nganya vehicles, you know, the type of hooting they make. The type of hooting they make. Others will just be making just any hoots. Another source of noise or sound pollution is, for example, in the airports. You know the sound an aeroplane will produce, or aircraft. For example, if an helicopter will land here, nobody will be keen on what they are doing. In fact, the sound from that helicopter can make everybody run to hell because it produces too much unnecessary or unwanted sound. Noise is unnecessary. Unnecessary sound. Another source of sound pollution, I know everybody has ever boarded these vehicles. Everybody has ever boarded the vehicle you call the Ganja vehicles. You know the type of music those vehicles play. So you have loud music. Loud music from vehicles. You are around 10 meters, but you can hear that that vehicle play very loud music with those subwoofers. What the type of sound they will produce. You are just in the vehicle, but you just feel like you can just close your ears because they produce very loud music. Even in some homes, we have the music home theater. For example, those who live in flats. You are single and you have just opened loud music because you are outside. So people from that plot will not be able to concentrate because of that type of music you are producing. So those are some of the sources of We also have sound from the Juakali industries. From industries. Those people who make the Juakali materials, objects, you know the type of sound they produce there. So these are some of the sources of sound. Now, what are some of the effects of sound pollution? Let us look briefly at the effects of sound pollution. We are looking at the effects of sound pollution. And one, we say that, will you be able to concentrate in a class that is making noise? So, one, it will lead to low concentration. There will be lack of concentration. You cannot even be able to, study well. Concentration. When you come out of a vehicle that was playing loud music, how do you feel? It can cause an headache. You can have headache. This vehicle will lead to irritation. Will lead to irritation of the ear. Your ear will be itching. You will be irritated in the ear. You will be hearing that very type of irritation in the ear. It can also lead to mental problems. For example, if you stay in that industry for long that produces a lot of sound or noise, you'll have some mental problems. Sound pollution can lead to mental problems. Sound pollution can also make one lose sleep. Can make you to lose sleep. You can have what we call the sleepless nights. You can just stay awake for a night because somebody is making noise for you or somebody is playing loud music for you. You cannot just open your home theater, your Sonitech radio, loud volume, and then you just sleep. You not sleep well. You can have loss of concentration. Sound can cause lack of or low production. Low production of milk in cows. Sound can lead to low production of milk in cows. Those people who keep bees at home in the beehives, in that area, if there's a lot of noise in that area, those bees will migrate. Migration of bees. Because they need areas of silence. Migration of bees. The bees will migrate and move to silent places because sound pollution will affect the bees. It will also affect laying of eggs in chicken. Laying of eggs in chicken. Those are some of the effects of sound pollution. So, for those people who work in the Juakali industries or in areas where there is a lot of sound production of sound, they have to wear things we call ear muffs. Ear muffs are things which look like they are not headphones, but they look like headphones. You can find them having headphones, not headphones, but they are called ear muffs. You are required or you are advised to put on ear muffs, so that they can prevent, because you have to work in that industry. For example, those who do the dual card industry, those every time they are hitting metals and they hit it loudly, so they have to wear those things, the ear muffs. They look like headphones, but they are not headphones. Don't say those people are listening to music. They are not listening to music. They are just preventing that loud noise, that loud sound from damaging their ears. Because, remember, sound pollution can lead to deafness. Can make you become deaf. So those are some of the ways of sound pollution and effects of sound pollution. Thank you.